हेलो, प्रेजेंटेशन इज विजिबल टू ऑल? यस, यू कैन अनम्यूट योर सेल्फ एंड यू कैन टेल। गुड मॉर्निंग। आवाज येतो का सगळ्यांना? अनम्यूट करून सांगा एकाने,
हो
श्रेयसाने।
सर येतोय, हो सर येतोय, हो सर येतोय, येस
प्रेझेंटेशन इज विजिबल टू ऑल?
सर।
ओके, सो वी आर स्टार्टिंग आवर लेक्चर ऑन ऑब्जेक्ट ओरिएंटेड प्रोग्रामिंग। सो सी, दिस इज द स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ युअर C++ प्रोग्राम। सो इन दैट देर आर डिफरेंट क्लासेस। दिस इज वन क्लास। दिस इज वन क्लास। दिस इज अनदर बी क्लास। दिस इज अनदर सी क्लास। सो इन क्लास देर आर डेटा। सो वॉट इज डेटा? सो लाइक वी हैव क्रिएटेड अ स्टूडेंट क्लास। इन दैट डेटा इज रोल नंबर ऑफ स्टूडेंट, दैट इज डेटा। देन स्टूडेंट नेम, दैट इज अ डेटा। स्टूडेंट एड्रेस, दैट इज अ डेटा। स्टूडेंट मोबाइल नंबर, दैट इज अ डेटा। ईमेल आईडी, दैट इज अ डेटा। सो गेटिंग ऑल ऑफ यू, वॉट इज डेटा इन ऑब्जेक्ट ओरिएंटेड प्रोग्रामिंग? विच आर द वेरिएबल्स यू क्रिएट? दैट इज नथिंग बट द डेटा। देन फंक्शंस, वॉट इज फंक्शन? सो फंक्शन इज ऑल्सो कॉल्ड एज मेथड। इफ यू वॉन्ट टू डू एनी टास्क देन यू यूज फंक्शंस, एंड दिस फंक्शंस कम्युनिकेट विथ अदर क्लासेस। सो यू कैन सी देर इज कनेक्शन बिटवीन क्लास ए टू क्लास बी, क्लास बी टू सी, क्लास ए टू सी। सो फंक्शंस कम्युनिकेट विथ ईच अदर। वी कैन कॉल दिस फंक्शंस। एंड when we create a class, we can create a object of this class. This is class A. Object is object A. For B, object B. For C, object B. So this is the diagrammatic representation of object oriented programming. Asha prakare tumhi classes lihu shakta. Class madhe data asto, functions astat, ani asha prakare apan vegvegle class lihu shakto. Class A, class B, class C. आणि ते कम्युनिकेशन करतात मेसेज पासिंग करून फंक्शन्सने। सो गेटिंग ऑल ऑफ यू, दिस इज द डायग्रामॅटिक रिप्रेझेंटेशन। सो बिफोर ऑब्जेक्ट ओरिएंटेड प्रोग्रामिंग देअर वॉज प्रोसिजर ओरिएंटेड प्रोग्रामिंग। सो इन नेक्स्ट प्रेझेंटेशन वी विल सी द डिफरन्स। वॉट इज द डिफरन्स बिटवीन ऑब्जेक्ट ओरिएंटेड प्रोग्रामिंग अँड प्रोसिजर ओरिएंटेड प्रोग्रामिंग, आणि त्याचे एक्झाम्पल्स काय आहेत। सो सी इन एक्झाम क्वेश्चन फॉर 6 मार्क्स दे आस्क, सो यू हॅव टू राईट 8 to 10 points रिलेटेड टू द डिफरन्स। सो वी सी डिफरन्स वन बाय वन। सो फर्स्ट इज द शॉर्ट फॉर्म। प्रोसिजरल ओरिएंटेड प्रोग्रामिंग इज ऑल्सो कॉल्ड एज POP, पी फॉर प्रोसिजरल, ओ फॉर ओरिएंटेड, and P for programming. In object oriented, short form is OOP. O for object.
Sir, screen दिसत नाही आहे clearly.
दिसत नाही आहे?
नाही दिसत सर.
बाकीच्यांना?
दिसती सर.
दिसती सर clear.
ज्यांना नसेल त्यांनी त्यांचा नेटवर्कचा प्रॉब्लेम असेल, जिथे तुमचं इंटरनेटचं कनेक्शन चांगलं आहे त्या ठिकाणी बसा, आणि नसेल दिसत तरी पण मी वाचतोय त्या पॉइंट्स। येस, सो प्रोसिजरल ओरिएंटेड प्रोग्रामिंग इज शॉर्ट फॉर्म इज POP, ऑब्जेक्ट ओरिएंटेड प्रोग्रामिंग शॉर्ट फॉर्म इज OOP. सो इन प्रोसिजरल ओरिएंटेड प्रोग्रामिंग इम्पॉर्टन्स गिवन टू द अल्गोरिदम्स। यू ऑल नो अल्गोरिदम्स, स्टेप बाय स्टेप एक्झिक्युशन ऑफ दॅट प्रोग्राम इज अल्गोरिदम। इन ऑब्जेक्ट ओरिएंटेड प्रोग्रामिंग importance is given to the data. What is data? You know already. Already in last presentation we have discussed. Which are the variables we create in the class? That is nothing but data. Roll number, name. If that class is a bank, then your money. That is the data. Then third difference, in a procedural oriented programming, your program is divided into different functions. And as in object oriented programming, your program is divided into objects. So this is the third difference. जो प्रोग्राम आहे तो क्लासिफाय होतो वेगवेगळ्या फंक्शन्स मध्ये. वेगवेगळे फंक्शन्स एकत्र येऊन तुमचा प्रोसिजरल ओरिएंटेड प्रोग्रामिंगचा एक प्रोग्राम तयार होतो. आणि इथे ऑब्जेक्ट ओरिएंटेड मध्ये वेगवेगळे ऑब्जेक्ट्स एकत्र येऊन तुमचा प्रोग्राम तयार होतो. नेक्स्ट, मोस्ट ऑफ द फंक्शन शेअर ग्लोबल डेटा. म्हणजे तुम्ही जो पण डेटा लिहिता सी प्रोसिजरल ओरिएंटेड प्रोग्रामिंग मध्ये ते सगळे फंक्शन्स ऍक्सेस करू शकतात. अँड हेअर डेटा स्ट्रक्चर कॅरेक्टराइज द ऑब्जेक्ट्स. सो यू आर स्टडिंग डेटा स्ट्रक्चर सब्जेक्ट, फंडामेंटल्स ऑफ डेटा स्ट्रक्चर. सो इन दॅट ऑब्जेक्ट ओरिएंटेड प्रोग्रामिंग ओनली ऑब्जेक्ट कॅन ऍक्सेस युअर डेटा. देन फोर्थ डिफरन्स, इन प्रोसिजरल प्रोग्रामिंग डेटा मूव फ्रॉम फंक्शन टू फंक्शन. As in object-oriented programming, functions that operate on data bind to form a class. So your data move from different objects of the class. तुमचा डेटा फक्त आणि फंक्शन्स फक्त ऑब्जेक्ट ऍक्सेस करू शकतात. Then next, functions are responsible for transforming one form to another. So in procedural programming, function ne apan to data change karu shakto. But in object oriented programming, data is hidden, cannot be accessed by the outside functions. Object oriented programming madhe baherche functions tumcha data access karu shakat nahi, tyachyamule apan object oriented programming ni security detoy आपल्या ऍप्लिकेशन्सला. सपोज यू क्रिएट अ बँक ऍप्लिकेशन, देन ओनली इनसाइड फंक्शन्स कॅन चेंज युअर डेटा. लाईक ओनली कॅशियर कॅन चेंज युअर मनी, दॅट इज डिपॉझिट ऑर विथड्रॉ. वेन यू डिपॉझिट, दॅट मनी विड बी ॲडेड इन युअर बँक अकाउंट, अँड वेन वी विथड्रॉ, दॅट कॅशियर विल डिडक्ट मनी फ्रॉम युअर अकाउंट. नो other functions, no other members can change your data. That is the security. Next, tumcha program kasa execute hoto? In procedural programming, top down, varun khali execute hoto. Ani object oriented programming, in that bottom up approach, khalun var execute hoto. Next, procedural programming needs very less memory. It requires very less memory, but object oriented programs need more memory. Then next example, which languages support procedural programming? So C programming, Fortran programming, which are the examples of procedural oriented programming. And in object oriented, C++, Java, .NET, these are the examples of object oriented programming. Then next, in procedural programming, there are no any access specifiers. Access specifier we have seen in first program, we have used public keyword. That is the access specifier. So in object oriented programming, there are access specifiers like private, public, protected. In this way, we can give security to our data. Private means only that class can access your data. Private. Then public means all the classes can access. Protected means in inheritance your data can be accessed. So in this way, your procedural oriented programming is less secure and object oriented programming is more secure. Then in procedural oriented, we can't use overloading. So there is no overloading. But in object oriented programming, we can do operator overloading. We can do function overloading. So this is the difference between procedural oriented programming and object oriented programming. So object oriented program require more memory. Still it is used in industry. Why? Because it is more secure. Most of the applications, most of the software is built using object oriented programming like Java, .NET, and in last century in C++ also some applications has created. So getting all of you, if in an exam question like this, the difference between procedural oriented programming and object oriented programming, you have to write 8 to 10 points and you have to write in tabular format so that you will get full marks. Also they will ask what is the difference between C and C++. So C is the procedural oriented language, so you have to write this column, and in C++ that is object oriented programming, so same points you can write. So getting all of you, ekada point kalal nasel tar vichara difference madla. So we move to the next presentation. So introduction to object oriented programming. In last lecture we have seen direct programs, so we see little bit theory about this object oriented programming. So first, in object oriented programming, emphasis is given on the data rather than the procedure. Procedural oriented programming madhe tumcha procedure var, tumcha algorithm var importance dila jato, but in object oriented programming, emphasis means importance is given on the data, because your data is very precious. So in OP, importance is given on data. Then second, in object oriented programming, your program is divided into objects. Different classes come together and it form your program. And from class we can create object. Next, data structures are designed such that they characterize the object. So using class we can create the object. So in that we can use different data structures. So you know that different data structures such as array, stack, so that you will learn. Then next, in object oriented programming, your data is hidden, yes, and cannot be accessed by the external function. That is the security. Your data is hidden and cannot be accessed by the external functions. Only internal functions can access your data. That is the security. Next, when you have to do communication, then object communicate with each other through functions. Kasa communication hota, tumhi class pasun object create karta ani object communicate kartat dusrya functions barobar. Kasa object name dot function name asa kela ki to object function call karto. Next, new data and functions can be easily added whenever necessary. So when you create application using object oriented programming, if you want to do update of this application or any function you have to add, then you can add very easily. Kalte sagyanna C++ madhe kiwa kontehi object oriented programming use karun ekada application banavla asel, तर त्यामध्ये तुम्हाला काही नवीन अजून ऍड करायचे, तुम्हाला सॉफ्टवेअर अपडेट करायचे, तर ते खूप सोपं आहे ॲज कम्पेअर टू द प्रोसिजरल ओरिएंटेड लँग्वेज. Next, it follows bottom up approach. So execution start from bottom to up. Then basic concept, what is object, what is class, that we will see. So first is the what are objects. So some theory, objects are the instance of a class. Yes. So what is object? It is a blueprint. It is a copy of a class. Second, it is a basic runtime entity. So what is object? It is the runtime entity of class. Next, what is the job of object? Using object, we can access member of the class. What is the job? Using object, we can class members. जे क्लास मध्ये लिहिलेलं डेटा आहे, फंक्शन्स आहेत, त्यांना मेंबर्स म्हणतो आपण, ते आपण ऍक्सेस करू शकतो. नेक्स्ट, व्हॉट इज हाऊ वी कॅन क्रिएट ऑब्जेक्ट. सो सिंटॅक्स इज क्लास नेम स्पेस ऑब्जेक्ट नेम. जे क्लासचं नाव असेल ते, त्यानंतर स्पेस आणि ऑब्जेक्टचं नाव काय द्यायचं ते आपल्याला. फॉर एक्झाम्पल, इफ क्लास इज स्टुडंट, देन all the student in that class are the objects of that class. kalte ki sagyana object mhanje kay. suppose tumcha second year computer cha class asel tar tyatle objects kun asal. tumhi pratyek jan je student ahet te kay zale, object zale. tumhi te runtime entity ahat tya class cha, physical entities. getting? so this is the live example. so how to create class names space object name. so here class is student and student name is Raj, and after that semicolon. so in this way, in main we can create a actual object of that class. kalte ka sagyanna kasa karaycha object? class name space object cha naav. so mala Raj naavacha student create karaycha aahe tumcha class madhe. so I will write student.raj. so this is about the object. any doubt related to object? konala kalal nasel tar vichara. so very basic in object oriented programming. so that's why we are going very slow. to konala kalal nasel tar vichara kay asto object, kasa create karaycha. then next, class. so what is class? in object oriented programming, class is an entity in which data and functions are put together. so in class we write data. for example, in student class, roll number, student name, address. so that is the data. and functions, get marks, set marks, display data, these are the functions. so class is the combination of data and functions. so this is the definition. for example, class is a student. so in that class, in curly bracket we write data and functions. so data we write in private access specifier, we write private and colon. then we write some data like student having roll number, marks, and after each statement we have to write semicolon, that is the compulsory. then next, functions we write in public access specifier because we have to access from the main function. then get result, that is the function. so that is the get result is the function. so we are writing round brackets after that function ending with semicolon. and after these execution of these functions, we are not getting anything as in return. so we are writing void before that. void ka lila karan jeva ti function execute hoil ani end hoil त्यापासून आपल्याला कोणतीही व्हॅल्यू मिळणार नाही. जर व्हॅल्यू मिळत असती तर आपण इंट लिहिलं असतं, इंटीजर व्हॅल्यू, रिटर्न झिरो जसं आपण मेन नंतर लिहितो. पण ही फंक्शन्स एक्झिक्यूट झाल्यानंतर आपल्याला कोणतीही व्हॅल्यू रिटर्न मध्ये मिळणार नाही. सो वी आर रायटिंग व्हॉइड बिफोर दॅट, नथिंग. व्हॉइड मीन्स नथिंग, काहीच नाही. देन ऍज अ टीचर वी वॉन्ट टू सेट रिझल्ट फॉर द स्टुडंट, हाऊ मेनी मार्क्स दे गॉट इन ऑब्जेक्ट ओरिएंटेड प्रोग्रामिंग. सो देर इज वन फंक्शन सेट रिझल्ट, सो वी कॅन सेट मार्क्स फॉर दिस सब्जेक्ट, व्हॉट इज द मार्क्स फॉर इन सेमिस्टर, मिड सेमिस्टर अँड अँड द प्रॅक्टिकल मार्क्स. सो दिस इज द अनदर फंक्शन. And then when class ends, curly bracket complete, and after that semicolon we have to write. So all of you getting what is class and how to write? So again, see, when you write a class, you have to use a class keyword. So after class keyword, you have to give space, and what is the class name you want to give? So I want to give student name to that class, so I have given student name. And in object oriented programming we use access specifiers. So what is access specifier? So using access specifier we give security to our program. Apan ithe private access specifier use kela manje tumcha roll number ani marks fakt get result ani set result ya don functions fakt access karu shaktil, change karu shaktil. Baki cha dusrya class cha functions outside of that class your data cannot be accessed. So this is the security of object oriented programming. त्यामुळे आपण private लिहिले ते roll number आणि marks. Then जे functions आहेत ते public लिहिले का, कारण आपल्याला main मधून ते call करायचे. So get result and set result, these are the two functions. So after every functions we write round brackets. Every statement in C++ programming end with semicolon, and after these functions we are not getting anything, so we are writing void before this function. And end of class, that is curly bracket complete and then semicolon. Then data members of class, so which are the members of that class we will see. So variables declared inside the class are data members. So which are the variables? Like in class we have declared roll number and marks. So these two are the data members of that class. Then it has some data types. So for marks and roll number there is data type integer. So like that, for each variable we have to give data type. Then before that data we have to use access specifier. So which access specifier we have to give, either public or private or protected. आपल्याला कशा प्रकारे access करायचं त्याच्यानुसार आपण त्याला डेटा टाईप देतो. सपोज फक्त आपल्याला त्या पर्टिक्युलर क्लासमध्ये ऍक्सेस करायचं असेल तर प्रायव्हेट, सगळ्या क्लासला जर ऍक्सेस करू द्यायचं असेल तर पब्लिक, आणि फक्त इनहेरिटन्समध्ये जर यूज करायचं असेल तर प्रोटेक्टेड. देन दीज डेटा मेंबर्स आर ऍक्सेसिबल फ्रॉम मेन फंक्शन्स. सो दॅट डेटा मेंबर्स वी कॅन ऍक्सेस फ्रॉम द मेन फंक्शन. अँड हाऊ वी कॅन ऍक्सेस? First we have to create the object of that class. Data members apan class che kase access karu shakto? Object ne. So see, these are the data members, integer roll number, integer marks, these are the example of data members. Then member functions are get result, set result. So getting all of you the basic concept about the class, object and data members. So what we have seen today, But we have seen, again, see the recap. First, we have seen the how object-oriented programming works. This is the diagram we have seen. Then second, difference between procedural-oriented programming and object-oriented programming. Yes. Then next, introduction to OOP. What is OOP? What is data? What is object? That we have seen in detail. What is object? How to create? That theory we have seen. What is the definition of object? How to create? What is the syntax? Then what is the example? Then how to create that in class? So in class we have seen first definition, then we have seen example of which are the data members that we have seen. Getting all of you this? Any doubt in this? Any doubt? Whatever the taught in this half an hour.
No, sir.
So see, we see next conditional statements. What do we see? Conditional statement. What is conditional statement? Anyone know? Which are the conditional statements in the programming? So first is the if condition. What is the first? If. If condition. Second, if else. Next,
elif. Elif.
Elif, that is in only Python we can use. So in C++ we use if else. Next,
for.
For loop, good. For loop we are using. Next, can anyone tell what is the next conditional statement? While loop, then do while loop. So these are the conditional statements in programming. In each programming these statements are used, only syntax is different, so we will see one by one. Yes. So first we will see if loop. So can anyone tell what is the syntax, how to write a if loop? We see if statement. What is the syntax? If, and in a round bracket we use condition. If, and if we have to write in small, if and some condition. After that, no semicolon, because that is the loop, and then we have to write a statement and semicolon. How to write a program? So I will give one statement, that is write a C++ program to display student is pass or fail from marks. स्टेटमेंट कळालं सगळ्यांना? आपल्याला एक सी प्लस प्लस चा प्रोग्राम लिहायचा आहे, त्यामध्ये आपण मार्क्स एंटर करणार आहोत आणि मार्क्स करून आपण चेक करणार की तो ऑब्जेक्ट ओरिएंटेड प्रोग्रामिंग मध्ये पास झाला की फेल झाला. सो फर्स्ट व्हेन वी राईट अ सी प्लस प्लस प्रोग्राम वी हॅव टू राईट हेडर फाईल. सो इट स्टार्ट विथ हॅश इन्क्लूड इन अँग्युलर ब्रॅकेट वी राईट अ फर्स्ट हेडर फाईल. व्हॉट इज द हेडर फाईल नेम?
IO stream.
Then after that, what is the second line?
Using namespace.
Very good. Using namespace. STD. And important is semicolon. Then next, we have to write a main function. So what is the syntax? Here using U is capital. What is the main syntax?
Int main,
yes, good. Int space main. In presentation, that first letter is coming in capital. Again, we have to change int main. And in curly bracket, we write that code. First, I delete this so you can see. So yes, in curly bracket, we have to write first what we are getting marks. So in marks we are having marks. So suppose marks are 39, then we have to use if statement. So I write if and in round bracket I check. What is the passing criteria? Yes, when you can tell that student is pass if that student got more than 40 marks. Yes, then you can say cout congratulations, we give message you pass in OOP and semicolon. Then check. So we try to execute this program. Same program I copy in the editor. So let's wait. So what is our editor? Online GDB. In that we can do programming. So I want to do C++ program. So I want to change this everything and I have to type my program. This is the program. Something is missing. I have to write full program with header file. So let's add here. What will be the output of this program? Can anyone tell? जो प्रोग्राम आपण प्रेझेंटेशन मध्ये लिहिला आहे काय आउटपुट येईल याचा?
कॉंग्रॅच्युलेशन्स 40 मार्क्स.
सो लेट्स चेक. आय क्लिक ऑन रन अँड देर इज सम सिंटॅक्स एरर. कॉंग्रॅच्युलेशन्स बिफोर दॅट आय एम गेटिंग एरर मेसेज. So what is the problem? Can anyone tell?
Sir, replace zero three.
We have to write a double quote in message. When we have to display that message, we have to write in double quote. So let's again run. So that program run successfully and it is getting message that you pass in OOP. and see, I have given 39 marks, and for passing that we require 40 marks. Still we are getting that wrong message, you are pass. 39 marks milunai apan paha ite slide madhe tyala 39 marks ahet passing sathi 40 marks lagtat ani tari pan message ala congratulations pass. Tar ya madhe apla ek error zalay, kay error zalay ki apan ji condition lili ti chuki chi lili, marks are greater or equal to 40, then that must be passed, no? So let's change some condition. Kalte ka kay problem zala aplya madhe, 39 marks dile apan tari pan to pass dakhote, ka dakhote, can anyone tell? Ki apli condition wrong zali, apan
condition wrong.
Yes, so we can change that condition. Kay lilo apan condition? Greater than, then again we display run execute. So now program is executed and no message. So why? Because that student does not got marks than 40, so it don't go in that loop. Kalte ka sagalyanna hi condition aplyala change karava lagel, less than avg greater than. एक पण तुमचा ऑपरेटर चुकला, एक पण सिंबल चुकला तर प्रोग्राम मध्ये लॉजिकल एरर येतात. सो ऍज अ प्रोग्रामर यू हॅव टू टेक केअर ऑफ दॅट. सो इफ मार्क्स आर ग्रेटर दॅन इक्वल टू 40 देन यू आर पास. मग आता फेल झाल्यानंतर आपल्याला मेसेज देता आला पाहिजे, तर फेल झाल्यानंतर काय करणार आपण? वी यूज एल्स स्टेटमेंट. यस, एल्स, अँड आफ्टर एल्स वी राईट सी आउट. Sorry, you fail. Yes, and if you want to display that marks, you can again display again that operators and you write that marks. And here also, if you have to display that marks, you can write down again that operator and you write marks. समजला का सगळ्यांना प्रोग्राम हा इफ एल्सचा? सो नाउ अगेन वी चेंज इन द एडिटर. एडिटर मध्ये काय चेंज करायचंय? एल्स स्टेटमेंट वी राईट. सो सी, व्हेन वी राईट ई यू आर गेटिंग हिंट यू हॅव टू राईट एल्स ऑर नॉट. सो दिस इज व्हेरी गुड एडिटर. देन राईट सी आउट. Sorry, you fail. And how many marks you got, that student got, you have to display. Then you have to write again what is the mark. So now tell me, what is the output of this program? Can anyone tell?
Sorry, you are failing.
Sorry, you fail, and marks will be displayed. Again, check. Yes, you can 39. See in output. Sorry, you fail, and marks are 39 that is displayed. Then next, we change the marks. Now instead of 39, that student got 99 marks. Then we execute. What will be the output? Congratulations.
Congratulations, you pass.
Pass in OP and 99 marks that will be displayed. Kalak sagana if else statement. How, yes, you can, sir, use. Then next, you have to use if else, if else. Hi zala if else. Then next, what is the next statement you have to display? We have to use if else, if else, if else, if else. So if else ne fakt apan don condition check karu shakto, either pass or fail. But using if else if, we can check multiple condition. So here, using if else if, we write a program. Write a program to display. Display grade of student. Grade of student using if else if. Using if else if. So how we can use if else if? I'm writing the program. So that same header file I have to use. So I am copying some stuff from here. And आता काय करायचं आपल्याला ह्या प्रोग्रामचं आउटपुट काय पाहिजे? जर स्टुडंटला 75% पेक्षा जास्त मार्क्स असतील तर स्टुडंट पास विथ डिस्टिंक्शन. वी हॅव टू डिस्प्ले द डिस्टिंक्शन. इफ मार्क्स आर ग्रेटर दॅन 60 देन फर्स्ट क्लास. मार्क्स आर ग्रेटर दॅन 55 अँड इन बिटवीन 60 देन दॅट इज द हायर सेकंड. मार्क्स आर इन बिटवीन 51 to 55 सेकंड क्लास अँड बिलो 50 पास क्लास अँड बिलो 40 फेल. सो दॅट वी हॅव टू डिस्प्ले. कळते की सगळ्यांना काय करायचंय? ग्रेड डिस्प्ले करायचं आहे. फर्स्ट क्लास आहे का, डिस्टिंक्शन आहे का, सेकंड क्लास आहे. सो आय राईट हिअर परसेंटेज ऑफ दॅट स्टुडंट. परसेंटेज अँड आय राईट हिअर 57%. Then using if loop, if in that I check percentage is greater than equal to 75, then what we display? See out distinction. You pass with distinction. Next, for second condition, instead of else, we have to use else if. Else if, we have to change the condition. Percentage greater than equal to 60. Then, what is the class? First class. Next, else if percentage greater than equal to 55, see out
second class.
Higher second class. Next, mute yourself. So if your mic is unmute, you can mute yourself. हॅलो, कोणाचं माईक अनम्यूट आहे? इफ यू आर हॅव्हिंग डाऊट यू कॅन आस्क. यू कॅन अनम्यूट अँड आस्क. डोंट अननेसेसरली अनम्यूट अँड डिस्टर्ब होल क्लास. सो वी हॅव टू डिस्प्ले हायर सेकंड क्लास इफ मार्क्स आर ग्रेटर दॅन 50. सो लेट्स चेक. We write this code in the editor and we directly take the output. So come back to the editor. So this program, I take backup. Already in my presentation that program is there. So I change this. I have to display the grade. Yes. So header file start with hash include, then marks. So in this program we have taken percentage, else that e is in small, that you have to write else, then next else also that you have to write in small, then we have to give that message higher second class, then else if we have to give percentage if that is greater than equal to 50, then you got cout second class. Then last also jevda pan condition dyacha tevda pan deu shakto. So else if percentage greater than equal to 40, cout pass class, and last below 40 fail. So no need to give any condition, directly we write last condition else fail. So now tell me the output of this program. Can anyone tell what will be the output? Disto ek sagalyanda program. Yes, you can unmute and tell. जेव्हा बोलायचं नाही तेव्हा बोलता, आणि आता जेव्हा बोलायला सांगतो तेव्हा बोलत नाहीत. सांगा कोणी आउटपुट काय येत?
सेकंड क्लास.
सेकंड क्लास. सो लेट चेक.
क्लिक ऑन हायर सेकंड क्लास.
इज सम एरर गेटिंग मिसिंग कॅरेक्टर. सो कॅन एनीवन टेल व्हॉट द एरर? Can anyone tell the is the problem in my program? I have not closed this main. Yes, so we have to close this main. We have to write a curly bracket, and main is int main, so we have to write return 0 as the last statement. Kal sagana error kala hota evda mota. So I have forgot to end the main and write return 0 at the last. Still there is some error warning I am getting, missing terminating semicolon. Je double quote hote te dyache rahilet, double quote, double quote. Jo message deta tumhala to double quote madhe paije. So let's save again and run. So getting, what is the output? Higher second class. Why? Because that marks are between 55 to 60.
55.
Yes. So again, I write here 77%. What will be the output? 77% asil tar kay output?
First class. Distinction.
Distinction. So let's check.
Distinction.
Yes. Distinction. That student got distinction. Again check, change the marks, that student got 67%. Then what will be the output?
First class. Class.
First class. So check, execute and check that first class is. Next student got 54%. Now tell.
Second class.
Second class.
So let's check. Second class. Next, student got 49%.
Fail. Pass class.
Pass. Pass class. 39, not 49. Pass class. And if that student got less marks than 40, suppose that student got 29 marks, then what is the
fail.
Result?
Fail.
Fail. Fail.
So getting all of you? Program kalala sagyanna?
Yes.
Kunala doubt asli he fails. Okay, so we shift to the next. What is the next loop? If teen loop pahile apan, if, else if, and if, else if, else. Next for loop. So can anyone tell the syntax of the for loop? For loop the syntax. In for loop, there are three conditions. Which are those? If madhe fakta ekat condition hoti. Condition. For madhe teen condition hai. First, initialization in round bracket. Initialization. Second, terminating condition. Kevha to end hoil. Termination. And last, increment or decrement. Getting? So this is the syntax of for loop. So let's write one program. Write one to 10 numbers using for loop. Getting? So this is the program you have to write. What? Write 1 to 10 numbers. So again, this is the same, your header file and that. Then next, I want some variable. So I create a variable I, and it is equal to 1 initially. So I have to display 1 to 10 numbers. So last time what some student written, instead of for loop, what they have written? They have written 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8 9 and 10. So this is the right program. Correct hai ka 1 to 10 number display karnyasathi? Let's check. What will be the output of this program? Can anyone tell? Yes. Return 0 is missing, so you have to write return 0. Then execute. Output is correct. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. But what I have told, you have to use for loop. Put a for loop program madhe. So only your output is not checked in programming, your code is checked. So here you have to use for loop. So how to use for loop? So instead of writing in that cout, we use for loop. What is the condition? Initialization. What is the initialization? We have to initialize the variable, I variable. We have to display 1. So I is equal to first 1. Then semicolon, terminating condition. Kevha aplyala program end karaycha aahe? When I's value is greater than इज इक्वल टू 10. आणि काय करायचंय ते इन्क्रिमेंट करायचे, अगोदर 1 प्रिंट करायचा आहे, नंतर 2 प्रिंट करायचं आहे. येस, सो आय इज इक्वल टू आय प्लस 1 ही कंडिशन आहे. प्रत्येक वेळेस आय इन्क्रिमेंट करत जायचंय आणि त्यानंतर डिस्प्ले करायचंय ते. सी आउट आय, आय ची व्हॅल्यू डिस्प्ले करायची आणि यामध्ये स्पेस द्यायचे थोडा आपल्याला. येस, सो वी आर रायटिंग एंड एल, एंड एल लिहा किंवा स्लॅश एन लिहा. प्रोग्राम कळालाय सगळ्यांना? काय आउटपुट येईल याचं?
वन टू टेन.
वन टू टेन. सो लेट्स चेक, क्लिक ऑन रन. So no any output I am getting. Why? Can anyone tell?
That condition
is wrong. Yes. I is less than is equal to 10. So now again click on run. So this has displayed that numbers 1 to 10. So all of you getting how we can use for loop to display 1 to 10 numbers?
Yes, sir.
So now same program I have to change. I have to display the table of 2. काय करायचंय मला? 2 चा पाढा डिस्प्ले करायचा आहे. Can anyone tell how I can display the table of 2?
I is equal to 2.
I is equal to 2.
I is greater than is equal to 20.
Good.
And I plus 2.
Very good. Yes. So this we have to change. आता आपल्याला 2 चा पाढा लिहायचा आहे, त्यामुळे स्टार्ट फ्रॉम 2 आणि एंड कधी होईल 20 झाल्यानंतर. 2 10 20 आणि प्रत्येक वेळेस 2 ने इन्क्रिमेंट होणार. 2 4 6 8 लाईक दॅट. सो click on run. So I am getting the table of 2. 2 cha pada yetoy. So getting all of you use of for loop. Ekada tumhala task repetitively karaycha asel tar tumhi for loop use karta. So today we stop here. Your homework is you have to write 2 programs, one of while loop and second of do while loop. So this is the task for you. Karta yel sagyanna while loop kiwa do while loop cha program?
Oh. So oh sir,
what you have to do, you have to create account in this website. How you can create a account? You can click on the sign up when you click on first I copy my program. When you click on sign up, then it will ask you are having account on Google Plus, that is Gmail or Facebook. So using that account also you can log in, or you can create your new name, email ID, password you have to give, and you click on register. So all your program will be saved on this website. तुमचे जे सगळे प्रोग्राम्स जे तुम्ही प्रॅक्टिस कराल ते सगळे प्रोग्राम्स सेव्ह होतील. आणि तुमचं सबमिशन पण आपण याच वेबसाईटवरून घेणार आहे, तर त्याचे जे इन्फॉर्मेशन आहे ती मी व्हॉट्सअप ग्रुपवर पोस्ट करेल, की हाऊ यू कॅन क्रिएट अ अकाउंट, हाऊ यू कॅन क्रिएट अ क्लासरूम. सो फर्स्ट क्लिक ऑन द क्लासरूम, then I log in with my Gmail. So first I create my teacher account, our college name. Yes. this I have created. Then I click on add and I will give some assignment for you. So I first give the class name. So I write SC computer class. So first I write our college name, Parikrama SC computer. Click on OK, the class is created. Then I can edit that class. I go in that class and I am giving this link. So using this link, you log in. Getting? So he link me tumcha chat madhe taktoy. Or you can take a screenshot of that also. I write on this presentation. This is the link. You can take screenshot of that. So on this, you have to submit assignments. I also post on our chat. So in chat, so using this you can log in and I am adding some assignment for you. So due date I set of this assignment is till 27th. I give 1 week period to submit your assignment. Then I want to give 28th. Okay, then next I want to give title, write a program to display your name. So language you have to use as C++. Then manually I will check that code. Sample code I don't want to give because the hello world program you already know. And I will display this. I will give title CPP program to display name. Then I click on publish. I click on save. First. Then I click on preview. So in this way, you will get that. And I click on the publish. So in this way, I have given first assignment CPP program to display a message. So yeah, program's output kai paije. Hello Raj. Raj naav asel tar hello Raj. Je tumcha naav asel te il hello ABC, hello Rahul, hello Smita, like that output must be there. So getting all of you. So like this way you have to submit your assignment online. If you are having any problem, then you can post on that group. I will reply you. अशा प्रकारे प्रत्येक लेक्चर नंतर तुम्हाला 4-5 प्रोग्रामचे असाइनमेंट असतील, ते तुम्हाला छोटे छोटे प्रोग्राम असे सबमिट करायचे आहेत. सो टुडे वी एंड अवर लेक्चर हेअर. राइट युअर नेम्स इन चॅट बॉक्स.